Do you have questions about automations in Home Assistant? Well, in this first in a series of videos dedicated to Home Assistant automations, I'm going to take you through a moderate example of an automation, and in the process, we'll discuss what makes up an automation. First of all, if you're new here, my name is John, and here at Hascasts, we cover things like home automation tips, tricks, product reviews, as well as home automation tutorials, just like this one. So if you're new here and you fancy becoming a part of the community, then why not subscribe, ring that bell, and that way you'll be kept up to date when my next video is released. Okay, so what makes up an automation in Home Assistant? Well, there are three parts. The first is a trigger. A trigger is something that you want to respond to. So it could be a time, say 0530, or it could be an event such as somebody flicking in a light switch on or off. And next are conditions. So what are conditions? Well, if you think about a condition as a certain set of criteria that you want to make sure are adhered to in order for the automation to take place, such as we don't want a school alarm to go off on a weekend. We only want it to go off on weekdays. And lastly, there are actions. Actions are pretty much self-explanatory. What do we want to do? So at 0530, as long as it isn't a weekend or a public holiday, the action that we want to take is we want to wake everybody in the house up because we're horrible. But how do we create automations in Home Assistant, I hear you ask? Did I? Yes, I did. Right, so there are two main ways. The first one is by using a graphical user interface editor, GUI editor. And basically, this is relatively new, a few months old or so. And what it allows you to do is it allows you to enter into the Home Assistant page itself a certain set of triggers, conditions, and actions. However, because it is relatively new and the developers are still working on it, obviously, there are certain limitations to what it can and what it can't do. So what if we want to craft a bit of a more complex automation? Well, in that case, we would need to use a text editor of some sort, a dedicated code editor. There is also an add-on for Home Assistant called Configurator. And that will allow you to edit your YAML configuration files from within Home Assistant itself. I've already done a few videos on installing Configurator. So if you want to check those out, we'll put an interactive card in the top corner. Feel free to check the videos out. So what code editor you use depends on your experience and what operating system you're using. If you're using something like Microsoft Windows and you have little or no coding experience, then you could use something like Notepad++, which I believe has syntax highlighting, so it does all the pretty colours for you. And I believe it is free, but don't hold me to that. However, if you're an experienced software engineer or something similar, then you will be familiar with code and you will have an entire plethora of tools at your disposal, quite a few of which you will already know about, so I will not go into it. Okay, let's move on to our home automation example. Right, so remember I said there were three separate parts. The first part is the trigger, which is what we want to respond to. So in this case, the trigger is going to be at a time, and the time is going to be 0530. So for you non-military folk, that's 5:30 in the morning. Yes, there's a 5:30 in the morning. And the second part, what conditions do we want to put in place? Well, we don't want to be woken up on a weekend at 0530. No. So first condition, it's got to be Monday to Friday. Second condition, we don't want to be woken up on a public holiday. So here in the UK, we have bank holidays. I believe over in America, you have something like Veterans Day, which I would hope is a public holiday. And if you're somewhere else, the chances are that you have some similar national holiday. So the action, well, this is a series of actions making up a moderate automation. And it all involves getting a family up in the morning. So remember I said that the trigger was 0530. So at 0530, the first action is we want to set the thermostat to the right temperature. So that means that by the time we wake up, the house will be nice and warm, ready for us all. Number two, the second action that we want to perform is we want to set the hot water. So we want to make it so that at 0600, if you want, you can have a nice hot shower. So number three, what we're going to do next, we're going to gradually increase the lighting level in the bedrooms. And this will simulate a natural sunrise. And let's not forget that people pay tens to hundreds of dollars, hundreds of pounds, on dedicated lights that will do this. However, we're going to do it for $10, $15 because we're cheap. So number four is we're going to wait until we get to number five. So in 25 minutes, we're going to get Home Assistant to flick the kettle on in the kitchen, make sure the water is nice and hot for a nice cup of tea or coffee. Number six, we're going to start waking the kids up first because they're always a nightmare. So what we're going to do is we're going to start some bird music playing on their phones, gradually increasing the volume, you know, tweet, 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 tweet. And we're going to gradually increase the volume over about 5 minutes. Number seven, we can do a similar thing in our bedroom, in the master bedroom. We can play some bird music, or we can have something like an Amazon Echo or a Google Assistant, Google Home, give us a voice prompt. Yo, John, wake up. Right, so now we're up. Number eight is we're walking downstairs and a motion detector that is out of our line of sight picks us up and it lets Home Assistant know that we're getting downstairs. So with that, number nine is we're going to automatically unlock the external doors with our nice, smart and secure locks. Number 10, if it is still dark outside, so if it's winter maybe, then we're going to make sure that the lighting levels are correct, ready for when we walk into our main living space. Now, once we walk in there, number 11, we want to get up to date with any important notifications that we've missed. Maybe there's an important email that we've missed. Maybe there's an important text message, SMS, or there's some breaking news happened overnight. Well, when we walk in, we can have the Amazon Echo read that out to us. Number 12 is the worst part of the morning. It's making sure the kids are up. So they're still not up by 10 past 6. So what we're going to do is we're going to tell Home Assistant, if the kids are still laid in bed at 10 past 6, then give them a verbal notification. Oi, kids, get your backsides out of bed, otherwise you're kicked out of the house. Morally, there may be some people who object to that. However, yeah, kick them out. Ah, but I hear you ask, how will Home Assistant know if they're still laid in bed or whether they're getting ready? Well, funny you should ask. I'm hoping to have a video coming up in the next few months or so. I've ordered the parts that I need. And instead of looking at a couple of $100 or however, a couple of thousand maybe, I don't know, dollar smart mattress, I'm looking at creating a smart mattress for $10. And that is how Home Assistant will know. Now, admittedly, we're going to need some third-party tools in order to create these parts to the home automation. And in future videos in this series, we will look at these third-party tools as well as exploring the vast ecosystem of third-party tools and different utilities that we have at our disposal. Now, if you've learned something in this video, then please hit the like button. If the next video in this series is already out, then the chances are that YouTube will start playing it next. But if not, I will let YouTube suggest a relevant video and you can watch it by clicking there. That's it for now. I love you all. Thank you for your support. Bye-bye.